Hey, what's up guys? Today I'm playing a bit of Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm going to show you some multiplayer missions. The reason why is because I did record a lot more of the campaign, but sadly my PC didn't record it very well, and it's got a lot of gaps in there, so I thought I better not upload it like this because I can't use it. So I've had to throw it all away. Don't worry about that happening in the future though, because I'm going to get my new PC. It's coming next week or something. I will be doing an unboxing of that PC and showing you the tech which in there, of course. But for now I'm just going to do Mass Effect multiplayer videos, because some of these were still useful, some of these were still not broken, so I can use these. So here we are in the multiplayer. I'm playing as the Asari Adept.
Hostile territory people. Secure this position.
The reason why I unlocked this in my fit, or can already play this, because you have to unlock these characters, is because you get loyalty rewards for playing previous Mass Effect games, as well as playing previous Dragon Age games, which I obviously have. I'm wielding an assault rifle. And I think a pistol. I haven't actually checked it. So yeah. It's a bit like Horde mode, this game mode, by the way, the multiplayer. It's, you've got three teammates, and you're four people in total. And you're just going to have to survive, and some ways you have to complete objectives. For example, rescuing a hostage, destroying like sort of towers or something from the enemy, and defending certain positions for a certain amount of time. But this time it just survived this round, because it changes every round. So it's just shooting everything that lives. Except your teammate, of course. Should have read it before I started the multiplayer. Hey mate, you're blocking my shots. How am I? Oh, damn, my shots, nice.
Three more to go.
Where was the last one? Okay, let's shoot this one.
Enemies nice. Clear. Stay alert.
Okay, that was the first wave. Supposedly every wave is going to be harder, of course. So I'm pretty excited to see what's
enemies
coming.
Headed your way.
I really, really like the jetpack in this game, by the way. You can really nicely fly around. I use it to quickly dodge into cover or out of cover. That's really, really nice. You gotta pick up some ammo though, because you quite quickly run out of ammo in this game mode. But there will be ammo crates laying around the map, so. Ooh, this one. Run. Okay, let my shield regen a bit. If you ask me, this feels the multiplayer Mass Effect pretty much feels like what Destiny should have been, but wasn't. So I really, really like it. Since this game has a good campaign, good story, of course. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but it's really, really cool as far as I've seen. Yeah. Good multiplayer as well, as far as I can see. Which is probably because I like Horde mode in Gears of War as well. And this is pretty much that, but then with a Mass Effect team.
Three more to go.
Let's see where they are. Oh, what? Oh, we've got a shotgun. Damn it. I thought I had a pistol. Too bad. Because I really, really like the pistols in Mass Effect. Well, the single shot ones, not the SMG style ones.
Sources say key data is scattered around this area. Find
and yeah, this is one of the missions where you have to defend an area for a certain amount of time. Like you can see on the top right corner, there's a time limit on it, and when the hack progress is 100%, reaches 100%, you're done, of course. And when an enemy is in the ring, it doesn't charge anyway. So, and I'm pretty happy actually that I brought the shotgun. Jesus. Jesus. I really, really like it if you use the throw biotic powers. They just fly away. If you throw them against something, it just does them damage. If they fall from a height, it does damage, of course. But if you can throw them off the map with that skill, and then of course it kills them. Help you. Stack. Stop touching me.
Just three hostiles remaining.
Yeah, they're coming right towards me. Nice. Yeah, that was on the way. Nice. Let's get some ammo. Oh wait, yes, ammo again. Nice.
Enemies heading your way.
It's just gonna survive again. Okay. No special objective this time. Oh. These beasts you see running around are pretty cool. They've got them in the campaign as well, and they can grab like your arm or something, so you're like locked into position and you have to press Y to escape, of course. But yeah, it takes a while, and when you're trapped like in the middle of a group of enemies, you're just going all going to hell. But so it is nice if your teammates are backing you up. But at the moment it's easy enough to very much run around and shoot. This is the bronze difficulty, by the way. Because the multiplayer has like three difficulties. Bronze for players between level 1 and 10, or it's recommended you can start at the highest one. You've got silver, which is for like level 10 up until level 18 or something. And you've got gold, which is 18 and higher, of course. But since I'm still level 1, since this is my first match, I went with bronze. Because just like in the campaign, in the multiplayer, if you level your character, you can unlock more skills and upgrade the skills. You don't have as many skills, of course, because it's quite limited per character which skills you have. But it's a bit like leveling up your teammates, your AI teammates in the campaign. Like, you've got, I think it's, 3 attacking skills and 2 passive skills. Something like that. And then several levels of upgrades, I think about 8 or something. Oh, they're sniping me. This guy's ruining my shields. Oh, I still have to unlock Krogan. I'm so happy if I get a Krogan. I really like the Krogan. I always wanted to play as one. Oh shit. Shouldn't have done that. Went in too close. But yeah. One's dead. Good. And as you can see, I used that consumable there to get to revive myself. Just guess why not? I was thinking I've got plenty of them anyway. I've got zero now, but you get them in effect. And you can pretty much buy a pack for every mission you do. Well, not the most expensive packs, of course. You're going to really have to save up for these, but the standard packs. And of course, this being in this time, you should know that also there are microtransactions in the game, of course. So these multiplayer packs can also be bought with real money, a bit like in Gears of War. And these packs can contain like armor upgrades, which is nice. I haven't had any of these yet. They can have more weapons, like different weapons. And they can have, obviously characters then. And it's not just a skin, of course, the characters in the multiplayer here have their own skill sets. So you're really gonna want to have actually all of the characters so that you can choose the one which you prefer the most. And even switch between characters for different missions if you want.
Enemies triangulating our nearest outpost. Find their sensor
array. Okay, we need to destroy the sensor array. I think we have to look around. Oh shit, he's behind me. No, it's these guys. Yes. Where is the sensor array? Down here? Oh, my team got already got it. Nice. No. I believe one of these Krogan had like a really cool flamethrower skill. Oh my god, what is that? That is a huge robot. Holy shit, yeah, this was is what I was talking about, that they can grab your arm.
One device down.
Let me kill this beast. Oh shit, shit, the robot's firing, no! Ooh, nice. But yeah, they can spawn bosses like this. And they're different types of enemies. Like, this is more organic enemies. Of course, we've got the robot now, but it's mostly organics we're fighting at the moment. Oh shit, shit, no, this is not a good moment to get grabbed. Ah. Ah. Okay, good. But we've also got these like robotic enemies, which we've also got in the campaign. Which you can also fight, which I will show in a later video.
We need that active tech taking care of people.
And disable these horses. Let's look around the map and try to find these things. I can't reach it, it's too high. Oh, yeah, here I can. Nice.
Hang in there, Apex.
Your teammate, you can destroy. Oh shit, there's an incendiary. Yeah. These grenades are so awful, it's like they set the ground on fire, as you can see. And you slowly die when you stand in there. They're really, really effective against targets in cover. But if used against you, it's like awful because you have to leave the cover, and most of the time you can't find a new one because you will have to go open and they will just fire at you with several enemies. But this being the bronze difficulty, it's still doable, of course. I want you to die. Thanks. Yeah, let's get up here and assist my teammates from above. Oh shit, I'm getting sniped. Nope. I'm just gonna just get off you. Yeah, the controls, by the way, are not entirely the same as in the campaign. Like, in the campaign you can press to hold the left bumper, I believe it was.
Just three hostiles.
Oh, that was in the previous Mass Effect. It's like, hold the select button, and you will get the weapon loadout. But in this game, it gives you the...
We're tracking reinforcements.
What is it called? The scoreboard, like, the names of your teammates and the amount of kills and everything. You press, you switch weapons by holding X, or on Xbox, it is X.
Time to go. Get to the extraction site.
So, a little different, but still nice. Oh shit. Behind cover. Oh jeez, all these explosions. But yeah, as in turn for the most deadly enemies, it's mostly the snipers. They're awful because they do a lot of damage, and most of the time they're like really, really annoying from far away sniping you. While like now the Krogans and these beasts are rushing you. But luckily you can easily see their targeting lasers. They're pretty, pretty big. And you can get a sniper yourself, of course, if you want, in the loadout screen. But you have to choose that at the beginning of the match, and at the... But I've just gone for what I already had on this character. I didn't bother to change it. Most characters start with an assault rifle and a pistol. But, yeah, this one apparently had a shotgun. I think I'm going to switch it to a pistol because I prefer the pistols. Because they're pretty accurate. A shotgun can only be used at like short range, but a pistol can be used at any range. There are still a lot of enemies. Luckily, we made it! Because it was the extraction mission. Where you just have to hold out until the ship comes and pick you up. So yeah, that was my first mission. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, comment and subscribe. And hopefully I'll see you guys next time.